Yes! So it has been a minute, really. Just going to give you a little update on what I've been getting up to. And yeah, so for anyone who this is their first time at my channel, hello and welcome. Remember to hit the subscribe button, please. And this is Mirror Mirror Makeup, but I do, I guess, lifestyle makeup, fashion, hair. It's all cohesive, isn't it? Especially with the beauty channels now, it's very cohesive. There's only a few, I think, that actually just do makeup reviews, and that's it. So every 3 months, I like to change up my channel just to keep the body guessing, keep it interesting. So the start of the year, January, February, March, I was doing makeup, fashion, blah, blah, blah. Obviously, if something is, by the way, the washing machine is on and the tumble dryer's on, I'm filming in my kitchen right now. This is like a vlog, this video. But if there's something that's happening in my life, like a holiday or a birthday, I will always vlog that, because for me, it's more than just content for this channel, it's memories. And they're like the only videos that I actually look back and watch again. Steffi, can come on in. I'm doing my first vlog back. This guy, you may recognise him from TikTok.
All right.
So, yeah, but if you are new to my channel, I know, is that not the most?
Look how many coca noodles we've got. Why not?
Lockdown thing you've ever seen. But we have got an addiction to coca noodles, so that's how we're buying them now.
Are you telling them all about TikToks now?
No. I haven't got to that. Well, what I was saying is my last sort of segment, come April, I joined TikTok. And the reason why is because I'm a dance teacher and it's the dance app, and kids, with the fact that the classes were closed, were wanting me to do online classes. That was never going to happen. There's too much involved in doing that, and I was never interested in starting online classes. So what my compromise was going to be, I will start a TikTok page focusing only primarily on dances, and I can communicate and connect with all the kids and their TikToks. And then for my YouTube channel, we were supposed to be YouTubing our renovation of our kitchen, but due to COVID, that never happened. So I thought, well, what I'll do is I'll start doing videos teaching TikTok dances, and the dances are like 15 seconds long. I don't need to go in depth like I would in a class, because it's recorded. You can stop it, rewind it, pause it, or whatever yourself. So I can just like, this is the move, next move, this is the move. So the videos for a 15 second dance are really quick, easy to make. So I was doing them every day. And it was a bit like Vlogmas. You know, by the end, everybody who's vlogging every day go, I'm just like, I can't wait to see the end of it. I'm burnt out. I got burnt out. And even though they were quick and easy, vlogging, still, I've got to put out a vlogging camera. Sorry, my throat in there. I've got to set up a vlogging camera. I've got to edit. I've got to put it online. It takes up a lot of time. And Steph's channel, Steph started like, so I started in April. He started a week after me. And his channel, obviously, it's a bit of everything and anything. There's food, there's dances, there's lip syncs, there's pranks. It's everything and anything. And
all goes.
I
access all areas.
When I'm doing mine, this is how I come up with the content for my dances. I go on YouTube, I look at dance compilations for that month. So like for now, it would be TikTok dances for June, and I look at the dances that the girls are doing, and I literally tick them off one by one. I learn them and put me dancing online. I started doing 3 a day. It's now went down to like 1 a day. Sometimes I give myself a few days off, and I do 2 or 3 dances to make up for the few days that I have off.
But you're always on my channel, so you're not even having a day off because you're on my one anyway.
Yeah, I know, but that's what I'm getting to. Steph's channel, there's a lot more thought goes into it. We really try and think about stuff that's going to not, oh, that'd be fun to do, it's all about, is that going to get views? Because he, it's crazy the views that he gets in his channel. So now we've went TikTok snobby on his channel, and we really put a lot of effort and think, no, like that. That's funny, but it's not getting views. Everybody's doing it. We're too late to the game. If we'd done it last week, we might have got views on it, but we're not. We have turned into TikTok snobs, and on Steph's channel, Steph's channel's the money maker. There's no money making on it, but
no.
He's got 10,000 followers. I've got 1,000 followers on mine, and I literally just go. I literally go on YouTube and go, all right, so that's what I'm learning today. Okay, I'll learn how to do it. Boom, that's my one dance done for the day. Right, Steph, and I put all my energy and to sit and do YouTube videos teaching dancing. At the amount of time, we could have banged out about 3 TikToks or more. It was taking, I just wanted to focus on his channel because, what is it you say? You say I'm the brains behind your channel? I am, I'm the brains. Okay.
I'm just the monkey.
You're
the organ grinder.
You came up with the concept for our video we're going to do today, but I'm the one that put the twist on it. So he got the video from Lad's Bible, the one we're doing today, and I'm like, okay, but you need to put your own slant on it, and I came up on how to put our own slant on it.
I think it's different music. Sorry, is that too loud?
Yeah, it's dead loud. Sorry. Tap running.
It's Jews.
So, the thing is, see that my YouTube channel, that when I was doing those dances, like I get on average about 200
views.
Like if I get 1,000 views on a video, I'm like, it's a one-off and it's like, wow, that was popular, right? I was uploading every day. I would get about 150 views on it, which is what I would normally get, even though this isn't a dance channel. And some of them I was getting over 800 views, 700 views.
On your TikTok?
On my YouTube dance videos.
Right.
So they're quick and easy to upload. There's less effort goes into it than doing a vlog style video. So, it's made me honestly consider maybe I should, because it doesn't fit the Mirror makeup brand doing dance. Like, there's a lot that goes on in this channel. It's a bit of a mixed mash anyway, between wanting to do home renovations, makeup, birthday vlogs. It's all a bit of a mishmash, but dance is totally left field. That's my right hand. Left field. I don't know even how it's going to come across in the camera. Right, totally left field altogether, and I feel that if I was going to do dance tutorial videos, I would need to set up my own dance channel. And you know, now that I've got a TikTok dance, dance page, maybe once I get to 10,000 on that, I might start a second YouTube channel. Teaching YouTube dances.
Another YouTube channel? Keep this one for like
this one.
And the other one for dance.
Well, yeah, because I wouldn't put dance on this. It would need to have its own separate identity.
It's going to take hundreds of time to.
No, that's why I'm saying I would do it. I wouldn't want to start from scratch again. It's all very time consuming as it is. If I got to 10,000, then I would maybe start another channel up from scratch again.
Oh, 10,000 on TikTok.
Because then I can bring people to the chat. Then once you've got to about 10,000, you definitely have like a group of people that regularly follow you. And then I could bring them to my dance channel. And it's like, the videos I was doing, they were aimed at mummies, because everybody over 30 gets slagged for dancing. Apparently, it's cringy doing this. Right?
And ratchet.
And ratchet, right? So I would show them how to do the moves and look with a bit of swag. Yes, that's where I've been, but I am back. I've missed it. I was focusing on his channel. I'm no longer focusing, well, I'm still focusing, but I'm ready to come back to what I know on YouTube. Apart from anything else, to be honest, I actually think TikTok is people's 15 minutes. As quick as you can blow up, it's as quick as you can get took down. There is so many. I'm not even going to say trolls, I'm just going to say grasses. Because trolling's one thing, right? Everybody's got thick skin. If somebody leaves you a nasty comment, like, big deal. But people are actually reporting it and taking you down for nothing. Absolutely nothing. It's given us the fear. We go live once a week. There's a lot of people that go live every night, and that's how they're building their following. But I'm looking at people's lives, and I'm watching people live getting their video taken down. I seen a girl, she was like, the kids on here, they were trolling her, right? They were saying, I don't know, I think they were going, oh, you're so good, look, I think they were like trying to take the mickey out of her. And she's like, is it just me, or is everybody's lives tonight going, the kids are going crazy on it? And then she read it, just seen her reading out the comments, she's going, I've just reported you. She's like, and she was about to say, what have you reported me? She went, what, why? And the screen just went blank. And she got our video got, like, our channel got taken down. I literally say it gives me the fear. People ask us to go on more times than once a week. They ask us to stay on longer.
No way.
We're not doing it. We're not putting the channel at risk.
I'm back at work. You're going to be going back to work. It's what we work. This is
well,
not a joke.
Well, apart from even if we had all the time in the day, Steph.
No,
the fact is that it causes. More trolls to come and visit you. I would just be happy with the wee solid Friday night crew that we have that join in.
The Friday night crew.
That's what we call them, the Friday night crew.
Is there some sort of effect on there? It looks like I've got lipstick. Look.
No, but I did put it a bit brighter.
And highly.
This is going to run out of charge.
Oh no.
Oh no.
Why don't you do like a rant about all the tea and all that that's been going on recently?
No, I'm not. They're just gross. They're disgusting. Like you said, the world is resetting themselves, and I think they're resetting YouTube and getting rid of all the dead wood that needs to, that should have been put out
months
in the rubbish.
And years ago.
Mm-hmm. And if anybody's on TikTok, you're getting a following, you're blowing up, then you really need to start taking people to your Instagram or your YouTube, or start set up a YouTube channel, because I think it's going to be short-lived. I actually do. You can follow me on Instagram, but my Instagram's rubbish. I'll admit that myself. I don't put any effort into it at all. Okay.
I don't like Instagram.
Okay, my video is charging. I did charge my battery. My spare battery I haven't even took out the packaging. So I'm videoing on my phone. I hope you don't mind, guys, just so you can carry on. You know, got a lot to do today. Got to do TikToks and that. So I thought I would give you an update on what's going to happen with the renovations of this kitchen. Kitchen is so bad. Sorry, I hit the button by accident on the side and it turned off my phone. My daughter doesn't see the difference between, this is an iPhone 11, but she doesn't see the difference between filming on your phone and filming on a camera, an actual vlogging camera. I don't really either. If you've got decent lighting, these are my windows, got big windows, I don't see the difference either. So under my sink I empty two buckets of water every day. I'm gonna empty it now just to show you. What? Oh, I need to use two hands for this. So, like, we fill up buckets like this. This is already emptied. And we've got to empty like two of these a day from under my sink. The cooker here doesn't work. And when we moved into this house, which was 3 years ago, 6 months later, on Christmas Eve, the cooker stopped working. Then it started working again on Christmas Day. And then the Boxing Day, it stopped working again. So we went, it's obviously on its last legs, it's been temperamental. So yeah, I bought a new one and stopped working last year Okay, so we were like, well, we're going to get a new kitchen because look at the state of the kick plates. This is how we came in, right? First of all, look, I don't know if you can see this on the floor, cracked tiles. Like, I'm like showing you everything. Look at the kick plates. Absolute falling apart. This kitchen is falling apart. We went, I don't eat anything out of a microwave, but we went and got a combi microwave because we needed to use something to make pizzas and chicken nuggets for the kids. A kettle. We've been sorted, we haven't starved. Woo. Sorry guys. So the kitchen needs done. Because we were planning to start at April, the builders coming in and doing it, our planning permission to knock through that wall, because next door is our dining room, I'll take you through. So this is our kitchen. The door here, that's going to be a wall. That's going to be our new supporting wall, because this is a supporting wall. So that's going to be our new supporting wall. It's all going to be bricked. And you're going to have one doorway, which is the dining room door, and that will, we're going to put a breakfast bar. Originally, if you've seen my video where I was talking about what we were going to do, I was going to have an island and everything. I've changed my mind. No, I think I'll utilize the space better if I make this more of a U shape in here and a breakfast bar, kind of more squaring it off. Okay, come with me. In here, as you can see, there's so many different marks in that from stuff we've hung on this wall. And fell off, it's a disaster, but that will be knocked through, so I'm leaving it because I don't care. And yeah, we'll have breakfast bar stools, and we'll move this dining table down here, and I can't wait. But when that's going to happen, who knows? Leicester's on its second lockdown, so we're hoping October, so we can have our kitchen for Christmas. If not, Christmas Day microwave meals. Well, that's grim, isn't it? It's absolutely grim. Also, Steph is going to kill me for showing you this, but we also plan to do the kitchen and the utility room, and wait till you see the state of the utility room. He's going to kill me, I'm showing you. Come with me. Okay, put light on in here. So let me turn it around. Look at the state of this place. There's like paddling pools, garden furniture. I've got dirty washing here. We have coat stands. Look, there's so much dust because look at the state of this. It's all falling apart. This old tumble dryer. The button doesn't stay in. We have to do this basically with the scooter, and the plug doesn't work anymore, so we have an extension cable that comes all the way through from the kitchen. So, and toys, look, cars and everything like that. People with OCD are doing this at the screen and they're watching, looking at this room. So we do plan to get this room sorted and have some sort of organisation and storage in here. And obviously a new tumble dryer is a must. Our kitchen doesn't have a dishwasher. I mean, I know it's first world problems, but like a house of five, and we've been used to always having a dishwasher. I hate always walking in and there's always dishes in the sink. I'm outside my garden and I'm going to show you what we are doing. Since we can't renovate the kitchen right now, we're going to get John a playhouse in this sort of, we've got a weird garden, there's pretty much like no garden. Look how small it is. This is my door, and this is the end of the garden, right? I know I need more stones. I need to do a lot of this garden, right? But the kitchen's priority. And I painted my fence. There's so many birds, which I'm going to talk about. I've kicked all over it. And I'll talk about that in a minute. But our gardener guy, who is my friend Karen's husband, is going to get all that grass out of that. That's supposed to be our drying green. He's going to get all the grass out of that and chip wood it
and then we're going to get like a tree house and stilts for John for his birthday. So that's what we're in the midst of, in the process of starting. And I'll let you, once that's done, I'll let you see that. Let's go to the front. As you can see, the sun comes here, it goes to the back of the house up until about early afternoon, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, and then it's here, right? So me and Steph wanted to somehow sort this front area out so we have somewhere to sit out on, but it's everything, it's on a hill. It's just, oh, I swear to God, the gardens in this house is the worst. It's the worst. Between the fact we have this small, the smallest backyard you've known in history, and then a drying green that's huge on a hill as well, and which you can't really do much with.
Dada, is this the right foot?
It certainly is,
Baba
Boy, you're very good.
Do you want to put your shoes on for him? I'm no kidding, right? We've got solar panels, and see, pigeons, they nest up under the solar panels, and see the amount of crap that comes off the gutter flying, like if you're sitting out here with a drink, flying into your drink. Eggs with the fetus still in it smashes down next to you, and it's like a stink bomb. It's like 10 rotten eggs have just exploded at the one time. The other week there, my neighbour came across the road to see me, and this like old eggshell with the fetus that was black inside it, with maggots all crawling over it, came flying down next to us. It is so gross, so disgusting. So how you combat it is you get chicken wire and you get someone to put that round the solar panels, and that stops them nesting up there. That'll be the first thing that gets done. Obviously we'll get more chucky stones and that put at the back, and some more seats to sit out in the back, because we've got a fire though, and the sun leaves there in the afternoon, but at night it's nice sitting out there with the fire pit on. So yeah, and we're going to get this all kind of decked and leveled out so we can put like a little barbecue pit and like a little, some dining room tables and chairs. So, and that over at this side, be some sun loungers. So that is the plan. Need to get the shades on, it's got so sunny there. So, Steph's mum's birthday, so we're going to go round to my in-laws, see old Frances, give her a birthday present, and we're also going to go and do some TikToks. Speaking of that, let me show you what I did to Steph's car for a TikTok. All right, we got a new car, as if you follow me, we got a new car to get rid of the Honda, very sad. Right, I don't know if you can, this will show up. Right, hold on, honey. Right, do you see all these like marks here on the car? I don't know if they're showing up. That's because I put sanitary towels all over Steph's motor for a laugh. Right, I'll show the clip.
Steph, come here, wait till you see the wings on our car. It's a flying machine. Wait till you see. Look at it. It's a pure flying machine. It's got wings. Look at it.
And now, when I went to remove them, I've just got like all this residue of glue everywhere on the car. So if you have any suggestions on how to get rid of that, please let me know. Help a girl out. And yeah, I need to crack on and need to get going now.